Everyone, in this video we look into the uterus and its features. The shown specimen is in anterior position. First, the dimensions: thickness 1 inch, that is 2.5 centimeter, breadth 2 inch and length 3 inches. The total length of the uterine cavity is 6 centimeter. In the sagittal view, it is shown as follows. Parts of uterus: the upper part, which is above the level of fallopian tube, is called fundus. The part from the beginning of the fallopian tube till the external os is called the body of uterus. Below the external os till the internal os, it forms the cervix. Cervix is further divided into supravaginal and vaginal region. Now let us look into the relations of the uterus. Anteriorly, if the bladder is full, it covers the uterus into full anterior part. Also, the vesico-uterine pouch. The lateral part of brood ligament of uterus extending from the infundibulum of the uterus tube and the upper pole of the ovary to the external iliac vessels forms a distinct fold known as suspensory ligament of ovary or infundibulopelvic ligament. It contains the ovarian vessels and nerves. Posterior relations are rectouterine pouch and the rectum. Now the arterial supply. The ovarian artery arises from the abdominal aorta just below the renal artery. It descends over the posterior abdominal wall and enters the suspensory ligament of the ovary. It sends branches to the ovary through the mesovarium and continues medially through the broad ligament of the uterus to anastomose with uterine artery. In addition to ovary, the ovarian artery also supplies the uterine tube, the side of the uterus and the ureter. Now, the other supply is from uterine artery, which gives some branches which reach the ovary through the mesovarium. Venous drainage. The veins emerge at the hilus and form a pampiniform plexus around the artery. The plexus condenses into a single ovarian vein near the pelvic inlet. This vein ascends on the posterior abdominal wall and drains into the inferior vena cava on the right side and into the left renal vein on the left side. Lymphatic drainage. The lymphatics from the ovary communicate with the lymphatics from the uterine tube and fundus of the uterus. They ascend along the uterine vessels to drain into the lateral aortic and pre-aortic nodes. Nerve supply. The ovarian plexus derived from the renal, aortic and hypogastric plexus accompanies the ovarian artery. It contains both sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. The sympathetic nerves T10, T11 are afferent for pain as well as efferent for vasomotor. Parasympathetic nerves S2 to S4 are vasodilator. Now the supports of uterus. They are divided into primary support and secondary support. Primary supports. These are muscular or fibromuscular. Muscular: pelvic diaphragm, urogenital diaphragm and perineal body. Fibromuscular: uterine axis, pubocervical ligament, sacrocervical ligament, transverse cervical ligament and round ligament of ovary. Secondary support consists of all the false ligaments. These are broad ligaments, anterior and posterior ligaments. Clinical anatomy includes prolapse of uterus. This may happen due to the damage to the perineal body, which is one of the chief supports of the pelvic organs. Colpotomy and colporrhaphy. Posterior colpotomy is done to drain the pus from the pouch of Douglas. Intrauterine contraceptive device is used to prevent implantation of fertilized oocyte. Uterus is common site of formation of fibroids.